how we doing the joint?
Check, check.
Hello, this is One Punk Army. Thanks for tuning in. Checking out a new game today. It's called Farsiders. Just came out a few days ago. Thought I'd take a break from my usual gaming that I've been doing for the past month. So let's dive into this new game and see how it is.
Enema, or what you people now call magic. It used to be a powerful energy that shaped our human history for centuries. Power, wealth, or even superhuman strength. Whatever we fucking want can be real. But every legend has its end. Greed causes wars, and wars destroy our civilization along with the Enema. Those fools! The lust for power, were the reason we had to struggle on our own in this fucked up world. But what if I told you that all hope is not lost? What if I told you that everything I've said can be true with this object? The Soul Codex. With this legendary artifact, it can create a new future for Ostalum. That brings us here, to the infamous Black Steel Island. The first step of our redemption. What happened there is merely the beginning of our journey, and their sacrifice is something that is inevitable. We, the Soul Syndicate, will retrieve what is rightfully ours, and mark the new era of magic. So I'll see you on the other side.
We're sorry to interrupt your evening with some breaking news. A major incident in downtown has been reported. Explosives were found planted just outside Greenham Water Rail Station, and authorities are still on a manhunt. We've been confirmed by Austal PD that this is the Soul Syndicate, one of the most infamous cults responsible for countless terrorist acts in recent years. Fortunately, no injuries have been reported at this stage. Thanks to the Spectra, Austal Elite Squad, the Spectralon, was immediately dispatched and successfully defused the situation within just a few minutes. Once again, the safety of this great city lies in their very capable hands. The new beacon of hope during these dark and unstable times. An awesome show they put on today. A great shout out to the world's best operative. Is anyone in Austal not a fan of the Spectra? We'll keep you updated on the story. Good night, Austal.
Let me take it from here, darling, because this story cannot be found in a book. 5 years have passed since the Soul Syndicate first appeared. The chaos reigned and caused a significant loss to the world. Unfortunately, one of Ostal's beloved protectors was among them. On a hope and a prayer, the Nuva Rich, Matthias Anvil, has proposed an agreement with Spectra to use his famous tournament, The Search, in order to crown the next Spectralon. The time has now come for the tournament's grand finale. Two rising stars set out to compete on Ostal's grand stage, determined to reclaim what was lost. Little did they know that their fates had already been sealed, and their journeys would reshape the future of Ostal forever.
Sanibop.
Hello, Marcia. How's it going?
Hi, Mop LUL. About to exercise C-Mop Flex, so probably abandoning you in a second, but I felt like saying hi, Mop Op.
Right on.
Are you having fun? Hot love.
Alright, so far.
Also, I keep thinking this game is Darksiders. I guess MOPT. I guess it's the only other Sider game I know.
Yeah, I saw this was just released a few days ago. I'm like, okay, I'll give it a try. If I don't like it, I could refund it. It's a little too slow for me. It would be fun if this was a little bit faster.
Diamophug wanted more fast-paced action.
I was also hoping for this to be a twin stick shooter, but no, you can't. The aiming's a little weird. Also, your sword attacks make you stop, and I don't like that. Fun.
Faith brings her back here, her childhood home, the Black Steel Island. Cassandra followed her robot companion and ventured down to the secret vault her father built years ago. Her breath hitched, shocked with the scene in front of them. Loads of bodies hung and lay across the floor inside the prison as lights came out from the wrecked bodies. The girl can no longer see those tragedies. Her vision shifted to the man in front of the ancient gate as memories rushed back to her. A familiar figure that was haunting her since the incident in Black Steel. A demon who destroyed her home. It was Sage. His hand held up a bright blue stone among those detained victims that drained the life out of their helpless bodies. The more souls that fly into the stone, the more gleaming and bright the stone becomes. In response to that energy, the gate begins to open. A gust of wind rushed out, revealing something that could take one's breath away. A portal that shines brilliantly beyond the gate. The image itself can attract those who stand in front of it. Cassandra couldn't believe what she had just witnessed. The ancient gate, the blue stone, and those unfortunate souls. Her baffled mind denies that all of this can be true. But before she could say anything, she is suddenly stopped by a young, familiar boy who emerged from the shadow. Standing confidently in his armor, Cassandra notices his gears are enhanced with exotechnology, and his dark eyes give a different vibe from the last time that she encountered him. More potent, more lethal, more soulless. Thank you.
Let's go. Thank you. Thank you. Hundreds of years ago, there was a kingdom called Ardenia, a peaceful kingdom and an alliance of Camelot. One day, the scholars
of Ardenia discovered the miraculous energy that was stored in the gem and flowed through the air of Talun. It was the magic that ordinary people hadn't recognized. They call that energy anima. The scholars worked hard to figure out how to control it. With abundant resources from the land of Contorium, they created Aether, a container that can store anima's energy and channel its power into a spell. But they won't stop there. With limitless potential, the scholars continued their research and finally discovered soul magic, the power that can drain the energy of living things and transform it into even more powerful magic. And in secret, they developed the deadliest tools known as the Soul Weapons. This brings us to the Soul Staff and the Soul Codex. The staff has the power to manipulate the soul owner's body, while the Soul Codex is an ancient grimoire that contains all the spells, summons, and how to create magical objects. However, these ancient tools need to be awakened before use. By absorbing vitality from living things, and it will take thousands of lives before it can reach its full potential. To balance things out, the legendary smith forged the Excalibur. With the moonstone attached to the sword, it has the power to cleanse all the magic. Its existence was meant to be the nemesis of the soul weapons, and when these two sides of power clashed, soon came the fall of Ardenia.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
I'm actually going to call it here, because I'm actually kind of losing interest in this game. So that's going to be it for now. Thanks for tuning in and watching. I'll be back tomorrow. I'm going to see if I can stream an event, call it Smorgasburg. And then tomorrow evening will be my usual Sunday evening stream, so I'll catch you guys later. Take care. Bye-bye.